I'm Haley from Southern PHC, and we are at AHR 2022. I'm at the TACO booth here with John Barba, and he's going to tell us a little bit more about ECM circulators.
Thank you, Haley. These are pretty cool. These are three ECM stainless steel circulators used for domestic hot water recirculation or for any kind of an open system where you need a stainless steel volute. And then we have their cousins over here, which are cast iron, typically used in closed loop hydronic heating systems. Each one of these circulators corresponds to the other. The 007E is a single setting, dead simple variable speed circulator. There's no programming to be done. There's no light show or anything going on. You put it in, you power it up, and away she goes. And she operates on one performance curve. The next one's the 0015E3, which is a three setting circulator. For people who like three speed circulators, this is three settings. So our first two settings, low and medium, are both variable speed settings. High is what we call contractor no callback mode. You turn it up, it's full speed, fixed speed, and away we go, right? So we have those three settings here for people who like three speed circulators. But again, low and medium are both variable speed. The 0018E is kind of a full featured, multi-feature, multi-function circulator. It'll do a bunch of different things. Anything from infinitely adjustable fixed speed. So instead of a three-speed circulator, if I wanted to go by watt, I could make it a 44-speed circulator. Go by half watt, it's an 88-speed circulator, however crazy you want to go. Then I have some constant pressure settings, proportional pressure settings, and then a Bluetooth setting. So I'm going to show you on its cast iron brother down here.
Please.
In the Bluetooth mode, I can connect to an app. When we're looking at the app, I have all the different types of settings here. Right now I have it set up in infinitely adjustable fixed speed, which I can use. I can set it up either using the dial or using the app. Now in the app, if I want to change the speed, right now I have it set at like minimum speed, 1%. If I want to change the speed, I use this thing, which I always carry with me, the ultimate tool, and I can just move it up to full speed. And then you'll watch as the dot, which represents the operating point, tries to find out hydraulically where it's going to operate. And because it's at full speed, it'll be operating right on the outer limits of that performance curve. If I wanted to go 50% speed, simply move it like so. You'll see the dot move around until it finds out where it wants to be. And then down low here, it'll actually tell you the flow, the head loss, or the pressure differential it's creating, the watts it's consuming at that moment, as well as the RPM at which the impeller's going.
Wow.
What makes this cool is like for a domestic hot water application, say I have a half inch return line. By code, the maximum flow I can have there is 1.6 GPM. Well, how do I do that? How do I know it's 1.6 GPM? With the 0018E stainless steel in the app, I'm able to do that where I can slow this thing down until I read 1.6 GPM or less down below, and I've set it up so we won't have an issue. I can do that right now. Just turn it down, down, down to around here, and we'll see what we come up with down here on the flow rate. So it's going down. Again, it takes a couple seconds to kind of figure out where it is, but now we're down, looks like it's about 3 something, so we can go a little bit slower down here. We can go even a little bit more. And keep moving it slower and slower and slower until we get into that level. So we know we protect the pipes, we won't erode the pipes from the inside out with high velocity, which the kryptonite for any pipe, as we know, is high velocity, highly chlorinated water, hot water, moving continuously through a pipe, that'll kill any pipe. This takes that velocity issue out of the equation.
Perfect, thank you so much. Follow for more information down below.